Hello friends, today we'll see difference between array of pointers and pointer to arrays in C programming. Content of today's sessions are, first of all, we'll recall the concept of pointers in C programming, then we'll go for array of pointer and pointer to arrays and their difference. Objective of our today's session is, at the end of this session, you will be able to make efficient use of pointers. You will be able to differentiate pointer to arrays and array of pointers. And at the end, you will be confident about use of pointers in C programming. Pointers in C. Here, diagram is explaining the concept of pointer where I is declared as a simple variable or an ordinary variable where 3 is assigned to that I and its address is 65524. Another variable J is declared who is holding the address of variable I and pointing to variable I. Now here pointer is a variable that contains the address of another variable. Pointer variable is declared as integer asterisk j pointer j where it indicates that it is a pointer type variable holding the address of integer variable, another variable of type integer. We can declare any of the pointer with any of the data type according to the requirement of our program. Here address of I gives the address of variable I. Ampersand I is a symbol who gives the address of variable I. This address can be collected in another variable by saying or by indicating J is equal to address of I. J is holding the address of I. Other way round, we can say that J variable is pointing to variable I. We need to remember one thing, J should not be any ordinary variable as it is holding the address of another variable. So that's why we need to declare this J as a pointer type variable, then and then only it can hold the address. As we have declared this J as of type pointer variable, that's why it holds an address of another ordinary variable. Now let's start with array of pointers. Now all of us are knowing there are different arrays we can use in our program. That may be of type integer, that may be of type character, that may be of type float, or that may be of type any of the structure. In the same way, can we declare the array of pointers? Other way round, we can say that can we declare an array who is holding the set of addresses? Yes, we can. Array of pointers is nothing but the collection of addresses. It is holding the set of addresses in it. All rules which are applicable to array of integers or character are be applicable to array of pointers as well. Now, we'll see one program which explains the concept of array of pointers. Here we have declared an array of size 4 with a pointer. It indicates that this is nothing but the array of integer pointers. Its data type is integer, that's why it will hold the addresses of integers only. Here we have declared four variables, I as of value 31, J with value 5, K with value 19 and L with value 71. One more M variable is declared which is used as the index variable further in the for loop. Before that, the array of size 4 is assigned with the addresses of I, J, K, and L for its index locations 0, 1, 2, and 3 respectively. The diagram is representing the same thing where I, J, K, and L, four integer type variables with its associated value and its own address locations. And after assigning the addresses to array, that is array of 0, 1, 2 and 3 are holding the address of I, J, K and L respectively. As it is an array, it is having its own address locations as well. They are 65518, 20, 22 and 24 respectively. Now let's go forward in our program where with the help of for loop, we are executing a printf statement iteratively for 4 times from m is equal to 0 to m is equal to less than or equal to 3, that is 4 times, to display the value available at the address array of m. Now let's consider what will be the output. Think about the program and let's think what will be the output. Obviously, it will give the output, that is value available at the address location array of 0 when m is equal to 0. Array of 0 is holding the address 65516 and value available at the address 65516 will be 31. So first printf statement, in the first iteration it gives 31. Next, it is pointing to J, so it will display 5. It will go to next index, this 65512 pointing to 19 and it will give 19 as output. And the last iteration, I++ array of 3, 65510 is pointing to L and it will display 71. This will be the output for this particular program, where array of pointers is declared and different four values and their addresses are assigned to the array. Now can we think like whether we can initialize the array of pointers with the array of integer, another array of integer? Yes, we can. Now let's go through the another example where integer array A is declared with the value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Array of pointer P is declared with the address locations of array A. A will be the address location for 0th index. A plus 1 will be for 1st index. This is for 2nd, 3rd and 4th. And the address locations are assigned to array of pointers P. What will be the output of this program? Now, before going for output, let's think about what the values are assigned over here in this figure. Address locations of array A are initialized to array of pointers P to the address location 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now, I am moving forward for IDE for the execution of this program. Now let's consider, this is the program where array of size 3 is declared with the 3 values, array of P is declared, array of pointers P is declared with these three values and what it will give the output. Now first of all let's think about only, that is value at the address P. What will be the output of this program? Now I am going to comment this for loop and currently we are checking the output for single printf statement and it is giving the output 1 as P, the base address of array, and value available at the base address of the array is nothing but the base address of array and the value is 1 and it is giving the output 1. Now to display all the values which are available at these different address locations, I am making one change over here. I am removing the comment for for loop and I am updating the printf statement by putting plus I. Now let's check the output. And here the output of my program is 1, 2 and 3 respectively. As it will go to the base address of array P, and the ith location and value available at this address location is nothing but 1, 2 and 3. Now as far as our program is concerned, where I am displaying these three different values, what will be the output for this program? What is P? This P is nothing but the array of pointers. Its base address is 65518, will get displayed with the first P. Next, value at the address P. So value available at the address location 65518 is nothing but 65510. So with this second value at the address P, it displays 65510. And the last one, double pointer P, is nothing but the value at the address available at the P is nothing but the value available at 65518 is 65510, and the value available at 65510 is nothing but 1. So it displays 1. Now move forward for output of the given program as I have just explained right now. Now what is pointer to arrays? Now arrays are declared over here. Array is declared with 5 values, and its base address we are going to assign to a pointer type variable G. Keep in mind the data type of array as well as the data type of pointer variable which is holding the address of this array must match with each other. And now with the printf statement, we are printing the value which is available at the base address plus I. We have just seen in previous program what will be the output for value at the address available with a pointer type variable plus the index I. What it will give the output? It will give the output 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the sequence. Another way round, if I am going to declare, just go through the next program where J is initialized within a for loop with the base address of array A. Index I is less than 5, so it will go for I from 0 to I is less than 5. And here I++ as well as J++ we are going to do. J is a pointer type variable. Can we increment the variable J, pointer type variable J? Yes, we can. Here J++ is nothing but the increment will done with the help of pointer type variable. As J is holding the address of integer type data, so it will get incremented that many bytes that required to store the address of integer value. If it is a 32-bit system, it will take 2 bytes. If it is a 64-bit system, it will take 4 bytes to store a single integer value, and accordingly it will get incremented. And here in this printf statement, we are just printing value available at the address location J. With this J++ symbol, it will go forward for next address location where the next value is available or the address is available for next index for array A. And now what will be the output? Let's think about what will be the output for both of the program. And now here, just at a glance, I am going to explain the difference between array of pointers versus pointer to arrays. In array of pointers, set of pointer variables are used where the addresses are stored that may be separate variables or the arrays. Here in pointer to arrays, single pointer variable is used and the base address of the array is assigned. Here set of addresses are used over here within a pointer type variable, and here it will